Radiant Team Pick.
Hello everybody and welcome back to the Game Show Global Esports Cup Southeast Asian Region. My name's Denali and I'm going to be your solo English caster for the second game between Pew Pew and Peng Lima, or aka Peng 5. So game one, it was a decisive victory here for Peng 5. They just completely dominated Pew 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 Pew. They had a draft which you honestly looked at and they would have been able to put a lot of aggressive pressure onto Peng Lima, but it was mostly Peng 5 to be the aggressors, and constantly they'll rotate their supports, they'll constantly go for these rotations, they'll get kills, and every time Pew Pew, unfortunately, the Queen of Pain, who was supposed to be their early to mid game momentum hero, just never came online. And unfortunately had to go for double Null Talisman for extra stats. And then after that point on, didn't even get to complete the BKB after a roughly 30 to 35 minute game. So for Pew Pew, bit of a weak performance in their mid laner for the first game. They did manage to hold on for a little bit with the kills on the Ember Spirit, but putting too many eggs in the Ember Spirit basket, and eventually the basket's just going to break. So Lakel's too much pressure on him to really hold the game for them. So Pew Pew dropping the first game. We'll see if they can turn this into a 1-1, whereas for Sukun Peng Lima, aka Peng 5, they're hoping to turn this into a 2-0 victory, as obviously if you 2-0, you get 3 points compared to the 1 if it's a draw between the two teams. So let's jump into the draft really quickly here. So Ember Spirit and Queen of Pain getting the respect bans here for Pew Pew, getting rid of their own heroes that they played last game. So it looks like they don't really want to give any of those heroes away, whereas for Peng Lima, they're going to get rid of the Tusk as well as the Undying here. So a lot of those really really tanky, strength-based heroes are out of the pool for Peng 5. So they do pick up the Doom in the meantime. So Peng 5 getting the Doom means that they're going to have a very strong offlaner that's also self-sufficient if he has to be. And he also has that one and only Doom. And Invoker probably going to be one of the primary targets this game, as Doom is so good on any of those heroes that do rely on a lot of their spells. And Invoker, without his spells, he's not really a hero. He's just a creep that looks good. Now Pew Pew in the meantime, they pick up a Winter Wyvern first, which is a very, very strong support in the metagame. The Winter's Curse is amazing at locking down that one hero and also catching out nearby targets. And also for the Wyvern, gives the team a lot of sustain and also just gives a lot of utility with all the slows that the Wyvern is capable of throwing out with the Curse. Sorry, not with the Curse, the Splinter Blast as well as the Arctic Burn. Now, excuse me, God in disguise, I'm so sorry. Invoker in the meantime though, this is a very early Invoker pick. Typically teams don't go for the Invoker so early, because if you show your Invoker hand this early, teams won't really get a read as to whether or not it's going to be Quaswex yet or if it's going to be the Exile Invoker. But Invoker is a very, very, very weak laner if he doesn't go for the Exort build. And depending on how Pew Pew is going to draft this, it's going to be a tough lane regardless. Going up against a TA, one of the strongest solo mid laners in the game currently, just because she can protect herself from a lot of the incoming damage that the Invoker can throw it to her. If it's the Exort Invoker, the Chaos Meteor will eventually break through the refraction charges, but TA during the laning phase is an absolute monster. So depending on how Pew Pew wants to lane this out, and depending on what kind of Invoker we're going to be seeing, it's really hard to say at the moment, as the draft is looking a little bit dry. Some teams do like to go for the safe lane Invoker to secure him that farm, but if you go in that direction, the Invoker has to pay off after 20 minutes. Because if you put an Invoker in that safe lane and he doesn't really pay off, and he's not able to keep up in farm with the other safe lane carries in that mid lane, in the safe lane, then it could be a complete disaster for the Invoker pickers. He's very, very, very level dependent. So the Invoker, I expect him to pick up a Midas this game just to keep up in levels and also to maintain that farm. Now, our bans for both teams. So Brood and Lich are going to be the choice bans here for Pew Pew. Don't really want to deal with the Brood Mother as usual, whereas for Peng 5, they get rid of even more tanky heroes. They get rid of the Razor, which would have been a good matchup for the TA, and they also get rid of the Slaughter, which would have been a very good hero to synergize if the Invoker went for that Exort build that we sometimes see. So, not really able to help the Invoker scale into the late game scenario, unfortunately. So with this, we're going to see an Ogre Magi pick here for Pew Pew. So Ogre Magi being one of the tankiest, if not the tankiest support in the game currently, with this ridiculous armor. I think it's like 8 armor, 7 or 8 armor at level 1. And then he's also incredibly tanky with a really nice HP pool. So with this Ogre Magi, I could definitely see some very early rotations coming out from Pew Pew. Ogre Magi is built for this. He's sort of like a Night Stalker, sort of like a Tusk, where you can go for these early tower dives and not really worry too much about your HP pool, as you can cop a lot of the tower pot shots. But Peng Lima, they're going to go back for the Dazzle. So that means that they will have some sustain, and also the Shallow Grave was going to be an invaluable asset for the TA. Because TA in general, she sometimes have kiting issues. So if she does get caught out and she does get dropped pretty quickly, the Dazzle will be there with the Grave, and at least the TA was able to turn around and fight. Unlike some heroes where if you want to Grave them, they just have to get out straight away. Whereas TA, if she knows she's going to die, she may be able to take someone down with her. So the Dazzle, going to be giving a lot of sustain, very useful. And also the Weave will be useful for TA. If you manage to catch some Pew Pew heroes in the Weave, that's even more negative armor for the TA to work with. Counting in that she will be popping those meld charges. Pew Pew now going to go back for a Viper pick. Now this is probably one of the older mid laners that we normally see. He's very strong in a one-on-one scenario. He typically is the mech carrier as well, so it seems like this is going to be a safe lane invoker, and the Viper will be shifted into the mid lane up against the Templar Assassin. So for Pew Pew, they should have a solid mid lane with the Viper, whereas for Peng Lima, obviously they would have liked to have an invoker Templar Assassin matchup, but it's just not going to be the case unless they shift the TA into the off lane, which is not going to happen unless they do for some really, really weird lane switches. But I really, really don't see it happening either. Like, Wyvern's going to be protecting them at least, and Ogre Magi will be nearby to keep the Invoker safe. Now, for Peng 5, they pick up a Clockwork. Now, this is very, very interesting. Now, this either shifts the Doom into a safe lane carry, because you never ever see Clockwork in any other lane except for the off lane. There have been very rare circumstances where teams find it viable to put the Clockwork in the mid lane, and normally it's melee matchups. Clockwork does not fit in the mid lane this game. So there could be a chance that they might be putting the Clockwork in the safe lane and maybe aggressive tri-laning with the Templar Assassin, perhaps putting the Doom in the mid lane. There's honestly a lot that Peng Lima can do, or they could go for the really greedy play and shift the Doom into the position 4 role and just jungle away. Just jungle away with the Devour and pick up something else to go into that safe lane. It's very, very greedy though. If Peng Lima get away with this, Pew Pew is not going to be able to contest with them. So very, very interesting for them to pick up the Clockwork here after they picked up the Doom. It could be a position 1 Doom, honestly. Doom farms very quickly, and if you put a Midas on top of the Devour, then Doom's going to be farming like a train. And the final two bans, sorry, is Rubik and Nightstalker, so no aggressive Nightstalker for Pew Pew and no Rubik for Peng Lima. And the final pick here for Vietnam, or Pew Pew anyway, is going to be a Nature's Prophet. We don't normally see this hero, but I guess the advantages of running a Nature's Prophet is he's decent in the offlane role. He's always going to be able to come in with a TP to try and help his teammates out, so he can just sprout in. He has a global presence. He can also push lanes to hell. So we may be seeing this complete split push rat Nature's Prophet that we sometimes see, the Octarine Aghanim's build on this Nature's Prophet. So this means that Pew Pew, they can go for an aggressive style, and the Nature's Prophet can decide to be directly within the fight, so he can just choose to indirectly be there and just pop one of his ults and he should be fine. So very interesting picks here coming out from Pew Pew. The Invoker pick, I honestly think this was a little bit too early. They could have just gotten away with a Wyvern and an Ogre Magi and that would have been fine. They would not have shown their hand to Peng 5 and it would have been great, but I guess they were expecting an Invoker ban? Highly unlikely though, but we'll have to see how this ends up. Lina, final pick here for Peng 5. Very, very solid hero to round out the draft. So it seems it's going to be a support Lina. I presume it's going to be that support Lina. Vex's going to be handling the Doom. We'll see how these lanes go out for Peng 5. A little bit of greed. Just a little bit of greed for Peng 5, but we'll figure out what's happening. I presume it's going to be that jungle Doom though. He is heading towards that bottom lane. So anyways, we'll introduce the teams really quickly here. So Pew Pew from Vietnam, we're going to have Lekkels in the top lane, picking up the surprise pick Invoker. So we'll see if this does work out for Lekkels. We have AK Racing playing on our Ogre Magi. We have Cry Killer playing on the Viper. That's going to be heading into the mid lane. Should be a pretty decent matchup up against the TA. Winter Wyvern We have Taffy playing on this Wyvern, so he should be having a pretty decent time in this game. I wonder if he's going to be aggressive. And finally, we have Red Devil, our last pick, Nature's Prophet. I'm really wondering how this Nature's Prophet is going to perform this game. If it's going to be that split push Nature's Prophet, or if it's going to be that very, very active fighting Nature's Prophet that we sometimes see. I'm expecting more of the Octarine Ags build, but it's going to be completely up to Red Devil how he wants to play this Nature's Prophet. Paying 5 in the meantime, going to be on the Radiant side, we have Vexus playing on our Doom, Sakri playing on the Dazzle, in towards Secret Shot we have Nova, ex-Nova, on our, what seems to be a support Lina, so support Lina, support Dazzle, mid TA, we have Meduin handling the TA this game, and finally, up in the top lane, near the rune, we have Oz playing on the Clockwork, who probably doesn't want to be here, and he's going to back out as he sees too much reinforcement coming in on the side of Pew Pew. So, both mids managing to secure their runes quite comfortably with no contest. So, for both teams, going to be happy with this. Obviously, you want to grab another rune, but if you can't get it, you can't get it. And Viper has a funny portrait. I think they did something to Viper's portrait. Doesn't seem quite right. But that's okay. It's not going to break the game. If it breaks the game, then it's just going to be a reborn issue. So anyways, how the lanes are going to turn out is Clockwork will be going into the offlane role. And it looks like they're going to be farming up the Lina. So Doom is going to be sitting in the jungle for the moment. And Lina will be taking this farm. Unless he just takes one creep and then he goes back to lane. He hasn't eaten anything yet. He's looking for a good creep, but not going to quite find the one that he wants. He will get a purge though that he could effectively use to kill off the Nature's Prophet. It'll be a nice setup for the Lina, honestly. But the range on this, it's pretty decent, actually. If he gets pretty close, just pops the purge. Even if Lina's nearby, then you just fight with an LSA. But there's not quite enough damage yet. If the Lina hits level 2, then I can definitely see them killing off Red Devil here. But these Treants are being so annoying. Because Lina, unfortunately, only at 530 base HP. Unable to really go through that. Well, first blood, observe ward on the ground. Mayday, mayday. Words on the ground, but first blood going in the way, pew pew. They really needed this, and it's going to be the Exhort Invoker. I'm so sorry about missing first blood. Should not happen, but it did. But Lekels, getting a first blood like this helps his farming speed by quite a margin. He's going to be super happy with this. Whereas for Oz, not the best situation to be in, but what can you really do? If you get caught out, you get caught out. Mid lane scenario so far, it's going to be even for the Viper as well as the TA. So for Crykiller, he's going to be okay with this, doing a significant amount of damage to the Templar Assassin. Still watching Red Devil here, playing with this tree, it's just harassing out both the supports. Now, fortunately for the supporting crew on the side of Pang 5, they're super squishy. So if they just get one tree and on them, they take so much damage. But look at this! This is 3 damage on a poor Dazzle with no other regen, and we may see another wraparound onto Oz. So Ogre Magi coming in. He's got no mana though, and Wyvern's gonna be the first one just to pop the Arctic Burn. Unfortunately, the Sunstrike will miss, so Oz will get out safely. He's got a salve and some tangos left over, so he'll be able to regen back up to full and head back into lane. There is about 40 seconds left on the Arctic Burn cooldown, so he won't really have to worry too much about that. And Red Devil gonna be slowed up and hit with a Dragon's Flame as well, but that's not gonna kill him. What doesn't hurt, doesn't kill you, won't hurt you. It's fine. It might hurt, but I gotta stop with this. I need to stop. The puns are bad. Stop. Bad day. No good. Can't do this. So Nature's Prophet is doing okay in this lane. He's not got much CS, but he is just keeping the supports busy. And LSA does connect though onto Red Devil, and this should be the end of the Nature's Prophet LSA, as well as the Dragon Slave, and Vexus just chases him down. So Nature's Prophet not really respecting the Lina. She still does quite a bit of damage at level 2. So, unfortunate for Red Devil to go down in that situation, but sometimes it happens. Oz, in the meantime, was being chased down. He won't die. He just pops his salve, and he's going to head back into lane. So, this Clockwork, he is absolutely fine. This mid lane is still very even. TA a little bit ahead of the Viper now, but that's because she is starting to get those levels that she desperately needs. And Meduin is hanging in there. But at some point, Crykiller should overtake this TA, just because of the poison tick damage, and also just putting more points into the nether toxin means that he's going to be doing that extra damage depending on how low this TA is in terms of HP. So Crykiller just picking up a wand in this lane, just wanting to accumulate those free wand charges so we can regen back up to full for free. And looks like Nova just wants to wait for the rune. No one's coming down as of yet though, so it looks like this should be a rune going in the way of Meduin if he does want to head down there. And the regen rune's up here, but it will change. Haste rune. Oh, this will be an awesome rune for both TA and the Viper if they want to pick it up. so they're just going to sit around here. Instead, the Wyvern's going to pick up the haste rune. Saw someone coming through, so just going to deny that from them. Crykiller a little bit low here. He needs to furry out some regen, and it looks like he will be. What is it going to be, Courier? It's just going to be a salve. So at least Crykiller has the regen to sustain in lane. But it looks like Pang 5, they see the opportunity, and they want to kill the Viper now before he salves up. And this is a small window. Can they get it? Lina just has to come out. Salve has been popped. Cancels at the salve. Oh god, that was so clutch. Ogre Magi killing off the clockwork, but this mid lane, this could be scary. Nope. Okay, they're not going in. He's so low though. That clockwork cancelled out the salve in the meantime. Did not get to see that, guys. I was so focused on this Viper potentially getting picked off, but that play from the clockwork, if it was intentional or not, it was so clutch. Just because it cancelled out the salve and it sends the Viper back to base. And Nova wants to go for a backstab as well. They want to kill the Nature's Prophet. He's got no mana, so he can't even TP out. The slow's there. LSA does connect, and Red Devil has gone back to where he belongs. Rest in pieces in the Dire base. So 2-for-2 is the score currently, 5 minutes into the game, and both teams are looking very solid. Top CS though is being held by Pang 5 with both the Doom as well as the TA. Invoker's gonna be up there too. So let's not count out Lakels as of yet. Graphs though is still in favor of Pang 5, it seems. Only by a small margin though, just because they're running that Doom. Doom just being able to constantly devour means that he's going to be running a slight advantage for his team if the game was typically supposed to be balanced out. So Crykiller is back in the mid lane, but unfortunately for him, he can try and go for a kill onto the TA, but he needs support, he needs detection. Top lane, O's is definitely going to be thinking O. More like an O crap. He does go down though. So Pang 5, they lose the clockwork yet again. Third time this game, so lots of aggression on the side of Pew Pew, shutting down the clockwork. He's only level 2. Viper, in the meantime, dies to the TA, tries to man fight the Templar Assassin, it seems, but the follow-up here was coming through by the Lina. So Viper dies. This is very good for Medua and the Templar Assassin, because he hasn't died to the Viper as of yet. It means that he's going to be getting the maximum amount of EXP and gold he is in this mid lane. He's being denied a little bit, which is obviously going to be there, but he's just being uncontested in the lane now. He'll have an EXP advantage. Bottom lane, we lose our Doom. Doom should not be dying under these circumstances, but it seems like he tried to go for a kill here. Gets caught out by the Wyvern. So nice pickup here for Pew Pew. These kills, though, are so... they're happening all over the place. I can never find them. TA was going to get jumped on, it seemed, but it was just the Viper. No one really there to catch him out. And this poor O's. He's still level 2. This clockwork is just not having the game. Just not having this game. Red Devil is level 6. So this Nature's Prophet is having a much better time because Pang 5, they need their supports to be aggressive. They really have to be aggressive if they want to maintain control of the lane. And if they stay passive just trying to watch a Nature's Prophet, then the other lanes are open to being jumped on. And O's, again, he's just going to get bopped on the head by an Ogre Magi. And cold snaps there. O's is so dead. Bang. And Lakels gets another kill. That's the fourth kill participation for the Invoker. And he picks up a hand of Midas too. So he knows he's having a good time in this top lane. So he's going to pick up the Midas. This is going to help him out so much. Similar to a Shadow Fiend, Invoker benefits greatly from extra levels. He needs the levels, he needs the gold as well. And it looks like our Wyvern's going to be caught out here by Medulin. Way too slow. Might get onto the high ground in time. He will, so just survives. Although he's going to get hit by creeps, so. And the creeps still see him. He will TP out. And unfortunately for the TA, a little bit too short range to catch out the Wyvern. So Medulin, with only 1 point, 2 points actually into the side blades, could not catch out the Wyvern, even with the extra visions. Too far away, unfortunately. So the TP from Wyvern will save her life. Instead, gonna try and go for a bit of a jump here onto Crykiller. He's in Viz too. He'll probably wait till the next creep wave before he tries to jump on this Viper. Still half HP, won't be the easiest kill, but he should be able to take it with a little bit of damage. So, depends if Crykiller jumps on top. Yep, right on top. There's the meld. Gonna jump on with the refraction as well as another meld. And Crykiller is pretty much dead in this situation. One more hit, that should be enough. And Medulin secures another kill for himself. This TA is getting... he's got 2 kills, which is not incredibly much. Doom being popped onto Taffy on the Wyvern. He will slow down Vexus, and there is going to be a TP in by the Nature's Prophet. Only the trees, though. Sprout's going to be there, and TP comes out as well. So Vexus, he gets out safely, and he won't even get the Wyvern kill. So Doom now going to be on cooldown for the duration. So it's not going to be the end of the Doom here. 80 seconds on that cooldown. But it just means that for the next minute and 20 seconds, there's no Doom. So paying five, got to be a little bit more cautious, not being able to rely completely on the Doom if they do need to rely on that spell. So clinging on to about 10 minutes into the game, guys. We have our Invoker leading at 4.8k net worth. He's got a Midas, so this is going to climb rapidly. Whereas on Pang 5, they're going to secure 2nd and 3rd place in net worth. So TA and Doom doing relatively well. And after that, it's Pew Pew with their Nature's Prophet and their Viper. And unfortunately, these two, Viper's not farming incredibly well. He's gone for a Ring of Aquila, surprisingly enough. And don't normally see this item pick up. He will be going for a Bracelet, so no mechanism. Instead, they might find a poor support in Zachary. Yeah, this guy is not going to be a happy camper. We'll be slowed down, and Sunstrike going to finish him off as well. No Nature's Prophet, the one to TP in to get that kill. Pangs didn't really want to go in there. No Doom, TA, unfortunately no Blink or any sort of mobility. Stuck in the mid lane here with Cry Killer, taking a lot of damage from the poison. So it seems that Pew Pew, they learned their lesson from the previous game, and they're trying to go for all of these aggressive plays. And this is the advantage of running the Nature's Prophet. He can just farm in the jungle, and when the time arises, he just ports in, and there's your Sprout. And even though this Clockwork has a chance of getting out of the Sprout, it's with the hookshot. You never want to do that as a Clockwork. He's level 4, 10 minutes into the game. This is not a Clockwork game. He really is struggling. If Clockwork shows his face in that top lane, Lakel's can solo kill him. And down bottom, oh god, Vexus. Vexus, Vexus, Vexus. Although, look at the poor Oaken Magi getting taken down. One more right click, that's going to be enough. They get him. And Red Devil wants to try and get a kill. They will possibly catch Nova, slowed up by the Splinter Blast. There was going to be a heal anyway. And Zachary going to be the one to get caught out here. He has a Grave available in the meantime, though. Templar Assassin killing off the Viper's head. Down at bottom, though, Staction's still happening. And they can't even get Zachary. The trees might be enough. Oh, goodness. Missed kill opportunity, unfortunately, down towards the bottom lane. And there's no mana left on these two, so no point in trying to commit. There's a hand of Midas recipe on the ground. I guess that's the Dooms? Okay, that was the Dooms. I don't know why Dazzle was holding it. Maybe he was just going to take it, TP'd into that bottom lane, and was expecting the Doom to come a little bit sooner. Who knows? But anyways, it does get delivered, and Maduin, even though low HP, gonna push down this bottom T1 with the rest of his team with a Blink Dagger as well. Midas gets picked up on the Nature's Prophet just now. So Nature's, he will start farming a little bit quicker, but they have to be wary though, because there is this jump potential on the Templar Assassin. So Maduin hoping to look for kills. So unfortunately for this camp here, TA not able to really stack that up too much, as there is the Observer Ward being blocked out. So PP respecting the ancient taking capabilities of a TA. Going to be blocking that out for a little bit. So for both sides, we're looking at an advantage to Pang 5, but just slightly. There was an advantage to PP for a while, but yeah, it's dipping back into Pang 5. So for the Vietnamese squad, they're not doing too bad, but it's just Pang 5 because of their Doom, running a Midas as well. And the TA also getting quite a few kills under her belt too. Just for Maduin, this guy is going to be such a big threat. He's going to pick up a Blade of Alacrity, so I presume it's just going to be the Yasha for that extra movement speed. Lakel has been untouched in this top lane. Untouched. 2 kills, 3 assists. They have to deal with him eventually, and if they leave him for too long, he's gone for this Necro Book build, which means that Maduin not going to be able to hide under his meld charges anymore, and also the mana drain from the summons really hurts Vexus as a Doom. Doom, unfortunately, has a really bad mana pool, even though he has a wand. It's not really going to be enough to sustain all of his spells. So with the Invoker picking up this Necro Book, it's going to hurt them by quite a bit. So for Lakel's, very good situation for him to be in. Viper might struggle, but the hookshot's going to be there. Cry Killer tries to jump onto Maduin. Maduin dropping very low. They will kill the Viper first, and Maduin going to go for a turn onto AK Racing. Wyvern's going to be there. Can they tick off the charges from Maduin? They can, but is there any more follow-up damage? Nature's Prophet comes in from the backside, wants the kill. Doom will be there. Can they actually get him in time? No, Maduin's still alive. Oh god, the extra armor, and all of a sudden AK Racing gonna have to try and race his way out of here. Slow down as well as the Laguna Blade, blinking by Maduin, and that's the kill onto the Ogre Magi, and Taffy has to get out of here. Maduin hunting him down. He will spot him if he passes this trap. He will spot him out now, but it looks like it's a little bit late to try and jump onto the Wyvern, and a mid tower gets taken. So Pew Pew, they lose a bit of a team fight, which it won't hurt them too much. It's just they're really making space for Lakel. He doesn't want to come back at all for his team, which it has to pay off. This time has to pay off for Laquelle. So after 10-20 minutes, once he finishes Necro Book 3 at least, he has to try and go for rotations and turn this game back into favor for Pew Pew, because their late game scenario is completely in this Invoker. Unfortunately, Viper's late game is very, very minimal. Tempo Assassin pops an invisibility rune. We could see a dead hero soon, and it could be Cry Killer. So someone might have to carve up his tombstone soon, unless he gets the Nature's Prophet instead, which would be a nice juicy target. And Invoker's nearby, so Red Devil gets hit twice, third time, blink forward, fourth, meld. Oh, couldn't pick him off in time. Nice sprout, but Madu, I'm going to run into Laquelle. Does not want to be here. Oh, doesn't get the Sunstrike. They will slow him down, but there comes our Clockwork to keep them away from the TA. And Viper going to come in. They get the Clockwork kill. They don't lose the Nature's Prophet, but obviously you would have preferred if you could have killed the TA. But Clockwork saving Maduan's life, definitely worth it. Not getting any kills though, it hurts. But they do not want to lose the TA under any circumstance yet. Maduan has to snowball, and you do not want to die if you're attempting to snowball. Oh god, Red Devil chasing after Nova pretty quick though, but gonna juke into the tree lines. We'll go for a TP out, and Red Devil can't get the hit. He will get it. He finds him, and Vex is gonna chase down Red Devil into the tree line, but here comes support. AK racing into the middle of the fray. Gonna go for the stun onto Sakri. They wanna kill the Dazzle first, because they know the Grave is gonna be there. So Sakri dies first. Vex is gonna be the secondary target. Is there a disable available? They have a stun in two. And Invoker's here as well with the with the Necro Book. So beautiful counterplays coming out from Pew Pew to jump onto Pang 5 the moment that they see a gank is incoming. O's will be coming into the bottom lane, but unfortunately this Clockwork not able to provide too much, as he isn't really rocking that many levels. He's just a level 6 Clockwork, 15 minutes into the game. For Pang 5, they really needed to get this Clockwork off the ground. He just came online a little bit too late, but there is still an opportunity for the Clockwork to pay off. He just has to be there to disrupt them. He needs the Blade Mail. I think that's the biggest thing for the Clockwork. He needs the Blade Mail to provide the most efficient way of helping out his team. They will go for a D-ward. So, a little bit of revenge. Wyvern, they're going to come in through the tree line. No one's going to really catch him out there. It's just a Wyvern. There are two heroes pushing the bottom lane. It's Invoker and the Nature's Prophet. And Nature's, he's got a Staff of Wizardry. I wonder what he's going to pick up with this. Is it going to be potentially... Okay, it's going to go for a Necrobook as well. So Necrobook for everybody, it seems. Necrobook for everybody. So mass Necronomicon build for Pew Pew. This could work out, and it could be a disaster, but Taffy in the mid lane gonna get hookshot by O's, but all of a sudden stuck in the meatball, and all of a sudden that Clockwork rest in pieces. Sakri wants to come in, but yeah, his Grave is actually on only level 1, so unfortunately for him, the range on it is tiny. Is there any disables to catch out Sakri? No, there's our Winter's Curse. They get the curse, and Nova's here. Laguna to finish off the Wyvern, but you lose the Lina in the process. And Nature's Prophet came in behind the tree line, going to take down this T1 tower. Meanwhile, Pang 5, they want to try and take a decent trade. They want this T2. Now, Pew Pew, do they react? Do they keep pushing? Honestly, they could keep pushing, but the TPs are coming in. Ogre Magi first. Slow onto Vexus. Is there anyone else nearby, though? It's just going to be the Viper. These two do not have the best kill potential. So this is just going to force them back, but in the mid lane, the Necronomicons, the Summons, the Zoo, pushing down this T2 tower relatively quickly. And Laquelle's gonna go to the high ground, and Vexus, no blink dagger on him unfortunately, so he's not really gonna be able to jump onto the Invoker. Invoker's gone anyway, so T2 gets taken, and unfortunately for Pang 5, they can't take anything in the process. They're just losing so much this game, and all of a sudden Pang 5's lead, this is only EXP, come back down in Pew Pew's favor. And here we go, same with the gold, it's dipping down. This is good news for Pew Pew, whereas for Pang 5, they're slowly losing momentum. But they can come back. They just need to get those extra couple of items and levels on the Doom and the Clockwork and get some clutch kills. Now, the kills will be obvious, but Cry Killer being the easier one. A bit of overkill to pop the Doom, but I guess they wanted to pick him off as quickly as possible. But here comes Red Devil, just goes for a sprout onto the Clockwork. He had some tangos, I think. Well, I think someone at least opened up the tree line for him. I think it was Doom. They will chase down Nature's, it seems, but Laquelle's, oh, you don't want to be there. Oh, beautiful sprout. They're keeping two in place. They will cut the tree line, and the supports are going to try and zone out the rest on the sidelines. So Clockwork keeping the two cores busy, whereas the rest of the supports being chased down. Laguna Blade, Taffy should be taken down here. And where's the rest of Pew Pew? They lose two. They're going to get another one here, it seems. And Pangs, are they going to try and chase us down? Yules, LSA, Dragon Slave, last hit for the TA. Easy pickoff here going in the way of Pang 5. Laquelle's has to be so careful. If he gets caught out, he is in so much trouble. No 4-staff, no blink. So if he gets jumped on, he's done for. The Doom will just pick up his blink as well. So it looks like they're going to concede any sort of push for the side of Pangs, but it looks like Pew Pew. They will keep this T2 tower for a little bit longer as Pang 5 going to keep on going throughout the map. So Blink Dagger's just been picked up on Doom. Did not go for the Axe. This will help his initiation so much jumping into the backside. So for Vexus, his number one priority at this point is to hopefully get a Doom on either the Invoker in the backside or to potentially get it on the Wyvern before the Curse comes out. Because a Wyvern without the Curse does virtually nothing in the fight. They can try and throw it to Red Devil, but he does a lot of physical right clicks. So for him, it's not really that big of a deal. They're going to try and find the Nova. With the smoke, nothing pops and realizes that someone has already left the tree line. Dazzle! Zachary picking up a bounty rune. So you got the medallion pick up on the Dazzle. So extra negative armor on the side of Pang 5. And Roche is available. So Pang 5, if they really want to, they can definitely go for the Roche attempt here. But the trees, though, they're going to spot them out. Rest in peace, those little tree men. And Medua not going to bother going in yet. They're just going to put some vision down so they can spot out if anything is going to try to take that Roche. Taffy. Oh, jeez. This is a beautiful rune to have on a Wyvern. This is going to give the Wyvern ease of execution when it comes to getting off that curse. But it depends if Pang 5 goes for the defense. There's only two down here. There's one in the mid lane. There's two down bottom. And look how quickly this tower's going down. This zoo of units. Two sets of Necronomicon units and Treants. That's disgusting. And the freaking Forge Spirits. You don't want to deal with this. So Pang 5, they're losing towers quicker than they can reinforce them. And all of a sudden, here comes a high ground. Taffy, still invis, looking for the curse. He will get spotted though, cast his spells. There is going to be the nukes thrown up by AK Racing to just slowly tick out some of the HP on the side of Pang 5. Commitment though, not happening as of yet. Crykiller a little bit forward, LSA doesn't land though. And Oz, he wants to go in, but he pops the blade mail, gets hit by the Viper Strike. And everyone on Pew Pew, they're going to back up. They don't really want to fight, but all of a sudden, I think they're going to get caught out here. Cryo-Killer tried to go for the TP, cancelled it, doesn't want to get chased down. Doom's going to be popped onto AK Racing, so Ogre Magi going to be a giant fat creep. But the meatball, the combo, thrown onto Vex is going to be melting. Curse is going to be there to make sure that Vexus definitely dies, but Taffy going to lose his life in the process. They will get Vexus with the nuke, so Taffy playing very well. But unfortunately, we'll get picked off here by Meduin. 2-for-1 trade. But advantage here for Pang 5. They did not lose their T3 tower. That was the major thing, but they're so close. It is actually in deny range, but obviously you never want to deny that tower yet. So for Pang 5, they're hanging on by a thread. This zoo, it's not completely breaking them, but it's essentially forcing the game out of their hands if they wait too long. And TA, he's gone from Manta style to make sure that she doesn't get silenced up. Is there any silences? Lina gets picked off. Is there a silence? I guess it's to get rid of the... after the deafening blast, I suppose. Meduin's probably really worried about that. But because he's gone for the Manta style pickoff, it helps him with pushing as well. But the thing is, it doesn't help him too much with damage. It gives him a little bit of extra HP. It gives him the mini purge. But aside from that, though, it really doesn't give the TA too much. He really wants something like a Deso right now, but he also needs to make sure he doesn't get caught out by some of these heroes on the side of Pew Pew. It's just so difficult for the TA to itemize the way he wants. He has to sort of play around how Pew Pew is playing. And the zoo, gonna start attempting Roche, but this is not gonna be a very slow Roche attempt for their draft. It's not that slow. They could come in time. Majora in time. They will get spotted by the tree though. They should be prepared for this, but the meld onto Lakel's doing a lot of damage. There's actually going to be a Cogs as well, forced up onto the high ground. They lose the kill straight off the bat, as well as the Nature's Prophet. And all of a sudden, this opens up Roche Crykiller in the Roche pit. But the zoo though, is it really going to do anything? No, Pew Pew. This Roche attempt just took way too long. They needed a medallion to at least do this quicker. And unfortunately, AK Racing, not going to be racing anywhere anytime soon. Gets a Laguna to the face as well. So four heroes dead on the side of Pew Pew. Winter Wyvern's the only one left. Has a curse though. So if he could potentially get the pickoff with the curse, that would be beautiful. But will be pretty hard. There's the curse. Only onto 05. They will get rid of the clockwork. They're going to try and go for a Sunstrike. But the Spinter Blast finishes him off. And Lakel's, is he going to finish this? Oh, Vex is taking a lot of damage. Doom picked up the Aegis. That's the biggest thing. Vex is going to get the Aegis and Lakel's will die here, unfortunately. He will get healed up by the Wyvern, but this is going to set up the LSA for the Lina. And Lakel still stunned up, but the damage is going to be there. And they're even going to blink up for the Wyvern as well. So Taffy trying to fly up to the high ground will be fine. Dragon Slayer will catch, but nothing will kill the Wyvern. If they waited a split second longer when the Rage was a little bit lower, then that would have been ideal for Pew Pew, but for Pang, the fight just went their way. They came in too early and Pang wasn't really done with Roche, but they said, hey, we can turn on you instead. We don't have to kill the Roche now. You two can't actually kill the Roche off yourselves. So Pew Pew, big loss, unfortunately, to lose the Invoker there. That was a buyback as well for the Invoker. So it was a heavy commitment. I didn't actually get to click the recap, guys. I'm very sorry about that. But that was a huge loss, unfortunately, going in the way of Pew Pew. And all of a sudden, it's gone back in favor of Pang 5. So Pew Pew, they had a little bit of a lead. Then all of a sudden it tipped in favor of Pang 5 simply because of a couple of team fights that went their way. Midur, oh god, Midurin. He has a BKB, so he's not going to be an easy hero to keep in place, but Midura could still get picked off. Even with or without BKB, it really doesn't matter. Still has to respect the PPU draft, and he will back up. Sitting on the top net worth as well, so this TA in a very comfortable spot this game. Red Devil on this Nature's Prophet. Now, he's gone for this Necronomicon build, but he's mostly fighting with this. He's gone for the little bit of split push now, so at least he's going to be a bit of a nuisance to deal with. But this is not the complete solution for Pew Pew if the Invoker plan backfires. Because Pangs, they can clear out creep waves quite quickly. They have Alina, which is probably one of the best supports to do it. They have a TA as well with them, with the Psyblades. That's just going to pretty much clip everything depending on the angle. Too many heroes up in the top lane for Pew Pew's comfort. And they're going to try and go for a back off, but the vision's going to be there. They will spot one. AK Racing. Going to get spotted out. And, oh, Clockwork getting Crykiller as well. So they're going to get two out of this. They get the Yoga Magi. Oh, their Crykiller might be able to get out. Oh, there's a Sprout to keep him in place, but the Doom's going to be there. They want to finish up Lakel straight off the bat. Ghostwalk or no Ghostwalk, this guy, he is going to be dusted up and he gets picked off. So Lakel's no chance of buyback either. He bought back previously in Red Devil. Yeah, I don't think the Sprout's going to save you anymore, my friend. Get picked off. Winter's Curse going to be there, but Vexus is so tanky, it really doesn't matter. I'm going to try and go for a Splinter Blast pick off, but that's not quite enough. And all of a sudden, Taffy melded up and stricken up by the Lina and our Templar Assassin. So all of a sudden, this game is just tilted way in favor of Pang 5. Pew Pew. Unfortunately, every time, Pang 5 just gets the initiation that they want. And if they get the initiation, it's so much easier for Pang 5 to execute, whereas for Pew Pew, they put everything into Lakel's and some into the Nature's Prophet, but unfortunately for these two, it's just not enough. The Invoker should be a little bit more farm than this. He needs to go for that split push style, but he just feels like he consistently has to fight with the team. He needs to fall back to that split push. He really needs to. Midura and just blinks out, doesn't have to fight. They will get a tower deny though. So a very minor win for Pew Pew, but it's not going to save them completely. Vexus now has an axe on the Doom. So all of a sudden this means that anyone that's doomed up, Vexus just stands next to them and they're going to be doomed for the rest of their life. Oh, this is not the kind of game that you want to play as an Invoker. This Invoker though is going to start struggling. What is his next item pickup? He's gone for a 4-staff after his Necro Book, which is going to help him with mobility. But it doesn't solve the problem where if you get doomed, you're done for. He can potentially pick up a BKB, but honestly, that doesn't really solve Doom. You're still going to be in a bit of trouble. So for Lakel's at this point, what does he go for? To try to overtake these Pang 5 heroes. There's just so much control as well as burst. It's ridiculous. Whereas for Pew Pew, a lot of their burst is quite RNG based. A lot of it's coming out from the Yoga Magi. Yoga Magi is doing a lot of this burst damage. Viper's not really contributing too much to the team fights, unfortunately. This is the weakness of Viper as we see it. He picks up an early mech, which this game, he honestly picked this mech up quite late. He could have been much earlier, but he was just struggling in that mid lane scenario. So for Crykiller, not the best place to be. And this Viper really is a nuisance. But he's not that big of a nuisance that you can just kind of ignore him to a certain degree. This Viper pick has really not helped out too much for PP's draft. If they had something else that could have picked up the mech early for them in the mid lane, then it would have been fine. But Majoran just going to kill off the Necro Book units and kill off all of those little poor summon treants too. And double damage TA. I'm pretty sure Pew Pew is going to give this away. No point to contest that with a double damage TA. So they're going to sit in the backside, whereas the rest of Pang 5 waiting in the tree line, ready to go. Hookshots available, although, oh, this is very risky. Even though Crykiller can take a little bit of this damage. It really doesn't matter. It's just a Viper. Look at the positioning as well. Everyone's just playing tree tag at this point. They're all just playing tree tag. They're waiting for their prey to come out, but it's just not happening. QPU are just so cautious. They know everyone's down there. So they're just essentially retreated. And Lakel's top lane. And he's going to try and go for the split push play, which I think he really has to do. But he needs a Necro Book as well. Because the issue with Lakel's is if you don't have a Necro Book and a fight happens, there's no damage for Lakel's. He's an Exalt Invoker, which is, to a certain degree, quite dangerous. But it's not everything to really lo and behold. Forge Spirits are going to spot out the Illusions. And not Illusions, sorry. The Forge Spirits. And they're going to just slowly chew on the Ranger Axes. And I kind of feel like they have to be in this sort of position to do this. And Lina. They're going to jump onto the Lina, it seems. Slowed out quite a bit, though. And looks like that's going to be enough. Taffy, in the meantime, going to get doomed up and also Cogs up. So there's going to be no Winter's Curse for this next team fight. And everyone on the side of PP going to be a little disoriented. Vexus, though, in the meantime, going to be slowed up and caught with the Nature's Prophet. So this could be the sprout of their lives. But Red Devil taking a lot of damage. But the stun's coming up from the Ogre Magi. It's not enough. Vexus is still healthy. The negative Urn Charge may kill him off. But TA kills off the Nature's Prophet as well as... Well, actually, Doom gets picked off by... Ogre Magi, but it's just a complete and utter nightmare here for PewPew. They're just losing so many heroes. The only one alive was Lakel's. And that was supposed to be a quick pickoff there for PewPew, but just wasn't quite there. They really can't do anything. Lakel's is just not running enough damage at the moment. The team fights are just so messy. And PewPew, it's just everything in Lakel's. If he can get the perfect 3-4 man Meteor into Deafening Blast combo, then I think that's the setup that PP needs to really go for this. This is just when you wish you had a offlane that had some sort of AoE crowd control. You wish you had things like Centaur, Task, Clockwork, just those heroes there for control. PP don't have enough control with just the Wyvern and the Nature's Prophet. Ogre Magi to a certain degree, but it's mostly single target. This Viper pick, honestly, if this was a different hero, I think it would have contributed a lot more than what a Viper could in theory. And we're going to have a bit of a duo push here, but it could be caught out. Nova, they're going to see Lakel's. Yul's going to be there. LSA to follow up as well. So Lakel's caught out. Hookshot as well. Laguna and Lakel's is dead. And this is just between Alina and a Clockwork. And Red Devil going to try and get away. He's pretty quick, but is he quick enough? The LSA connects. Oh, he turned around for a split second. And all of a sudden, Red Devil going to go back to where he belongs. They see him completely as well. Although these summons are being a little annoying, but they're not going to kill him entirely. Dazzle will get the ranged one at least, or Clockwork will. And Tia going to be there to get the massive bounty for the melee Necronomicon unit. So Pew Pew, they're starting to get a little bit desperate. They have to go for these cute little plays, but I don't think it's ever going to pay off. It's just paying five constantly at the right place, at the right time, every single time. Every time. And Pew Pew haven't gotten a kill for quite a while, it seems. And you look at this, and they get a kill on the Doom. But that was in the middle of a team fight where they lost most of their draft. And all of a sudden, high ground attempts coming out here for Pang 5. And Pew Pew, they're still missing their two major cores. Invoker doesn't want to buy back. The Illusions from the TA just going to send the Wyvern back as well. So this push is real for Pang 5. So Pew Pew, Invoker is back. But can they defend this? Do they really have the control for Ogre Magi? Are going to be the one to just throw the slow out first. So he'll just be there for a little bit of initiation, but T3 goes down and they take it safely. Mid lane, it's pushed all the way through, and we have the Nature's Prophet consistently pushing this out too. This is all they can do. QPU cannot really leave their base without being jumped on by so many heroes. So Pang 5 just keeping QPU under their control. There's just nothing that QPU can honestly do. They can try and go for kills, but the damage just isn't there anymore. The Viper doesn't do damage. Lakel's is the only one that really does do the damage. But the Dazzle is consistently there. Times like this where you wish you had an Axe. Axe would have been the perfect hero for taking down these super low graved heroes that Sakri has been saving. So it looks like it's going to be a Roche attempt here coming out for QP. Now can they take this in time? Do they have a medallion? They don't, but depends if Pang suspects this. And do they? They're all here. And Taffy's going to reveal himself in the river, so they should know this is happening. So Blinken and Vexus comes in with the plays, but the Aegis is going to be taken up by Viper. Not really the best hero, but he is doomed up, so it's not really a big deal. Vexus losing so much HP, and he will be graved up. Viper dies. The rest of his teammates are going to be out, except for the Invoker. Viper comes back, but he's effectively just going to give his life away. So they took the Aegis, and they also get Winter Wyvern. What? Oh, Wyvern died there. Sorry, I thought that was a double kill. But Lina getting a Nature's Prophet in the meantime. Every time, pew pew. They just try and go for Roche, and Pang 5 suspected it. If the Wyvern did not put that Observer Ward on the high ground, Vexus would not have suspected that Roche attempt. They really wouldn't have. I feel like... Oh god, this is just not Pew Pew's game. It really isn't. But Pang 5, they're just playing so perfectly as a team. They're just always right calls. Every single time. So what's Pew Pew doing? I can imagine having dived in his own base by TA. What? This is not supposed to happen, but TA says, hey, there's no T3 tower. I really don't care. She's got Daedalus as well, so she gets some lucky crits. Then TA's gonna get completely ham. Pops a refraction just as the Splinter Blast connected. It's just the two supports alive here for Pew Pew. Invoker's coming back, but him by himself, he really cannot do anything this game. Minus or no minus, he just really cannot. Yule's onto the Wyvern. Nova wants to connect, does not land the LSA though, so Nova gonna be in a bit of trouble. There will be the grave, but Nova's so dead. Oh, gonna go for a TP out, whereas Laquelle's caught out by Ooze, but looks like Laquelle should be able to get out. And has to pop his Necronomicon. They will get the kill onto the Clockwork, which is a very minor win. But in the meantime, Crykiller gonna go down to the TA and TA Sakri as well as Vexus. Vexus is pretty low though. BKB popped by Madura, and they're gonna try and control this TA. But is it really enough? They blinks forward, tries to get Red Devil, but the curse is gonna be there. But where's the damage? Madura's still very healthy. It's gonna drop pretty low, but there's the grave as well to keep him alive. He will try to focus down the Wyvern, but not really the ideal target. He will go down. No, blinks out just in time with a 17 HP. Laquelle's fighting up against Sakri. Slowed up, and I'm expecting a blinking by the TA at this point. Sakri gonna try and get out with the... Oh, God, we're doing... This guy just two-shot the Nature's Prophet. And all of a sudden, gonna jump on the Wyvern as well. 1k crit! Oh my god. This guy is definitely godlike. There'll be a TP in there. Ogre Magi, he wants a little bit of the action. Just goes for a bit of a nuke onto Madoon. It won't take him out completely. The tower will help though, but Refraction's back up again. AK Racing, he wants this kill, but he won't even get the TA. And Zachary gonna be healing up his teammates slowly with the urn and the heals. Pew Pew can just not get this kill. The TA is so elusive. He's dived once this game with a streak of 22 kills. I have no idea what the streak is exactly, but Madoon is an absolute beast this game. Okay, we're closing in towards a 40k EXP advantage. That is disgusting. Oh no. Even gold is creeping towards 30k. You know the game is over when you're this far behind. And Pew Pew just can't get kills. They get a kill every now and again, but it's not enough to slowly get this game back into their pockets. Blink on Laquelle's. What options does he really have left? I don't think there's any item out there that would turn the fight in their favor. And God, Matuan again gets the kills. Can we see if that was a crit? No? Okay, it doesn't even tell me if there's a crit. Meanwhile, in this lane here, Nova. Oh, they're trying to look for the Invoker. I think it may have just clipped him. They know where he is. Can they get close enough? They're Laquelle's gonna get spotted out, and they get the Doom. Laquelle's are so dead. Laguna, TP's in. Bit of overkill, but what the hell. Just make sure that Laquelle's is dead. Oh god. This has just turned into, well, a lot of people would say probably the end. The beginning of the end. Well, I guess the beginning was the beginning of this game, but regardless, Pang 5, such a dominating presence over this game, whereas a Pew Pew, it's just not there. And this poor Ogre Magi, I might get jumped on. Oh, hookshot connects! Ooze! He gets him. Crykiller pops his Manta style. But they're not going to jump onto them yet. Ooze, though, pretty tanky himself, taking a lot of damage. Doesn't even pop the Blade Mail, surprisingly enough. And oh, Winter's Curse. They really want the kill onto Ooze, but the curse is going to be there. Sorry, the grave. Ooze is still alive, and Crykiller gets hit by a couple of crits, goes down. Red Devil, same scenario. Onto low ground, actually misses, but the hookshot's there. Ooze gets a taste of action, still at low HP. And the rest of Pew Pew, what can they do? They're stuck in their base, and no damage, no Invoker, no Nature's Prophet. They've got all the utility heroes, just not the damage. Yule's under Ogre Magi. Nova, LSA doesn't connect. Hookshot doesn't connect either for Ooze. He hit a creep. It's okay, nobody saw that. But TA, they're going completely ham in the enemy base. Cry, mitigating a lot of the damage. Vexus wants to get a kill. Won't get it though. And AK Racing, gonna try and race it up against Vexus. Gets fogged. Animation a little bit too slow. LSA as well as the stun. Stun doesn't connect, but AK Racing's okay. and all the Raxes are gone. And Lakels, he wants a kill, doesn't even get this on the TA. She just blinks out. Oh no, Lakels. Just can't get the combo off, and this is pretty much it. Mega Creeps going in the way of Pang 5 and Pew Pew. Their chances of winning this game are so slim. Doom onto Cry Killer, and he is dying so quickly. It'll be the heal, but Laguna just finished them off. Pure 850 damage. So disgusting. Clockwork misses the hookshot. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay, Oz. This Clockwork had such a difficult early game, and his team just helping him get that space, making him relevant again. Lakels just having to pop his ghost step. The Ogre Magic gets a kill on the Clockwork. AK Racing, the hero. The hero. Oh no, Red Devil wanted the courier. The poor AK Racing. He's going to go down. Nature's probably wants to get a kill onto Vexus. Can they get it? Lina's there taking a lot of damage from the Lina. Going to try and finish him off. He's too fast. He's too tanky. And the Necrobooks can't even get him as Nova finishes off the Nature's Prophet. The buybacks are real. It's still happening. Pew pew. I think at this point they're just wanting to have a little bit of fun here. Maduan just melting through the heroes. LSA Curse is going to be there. Can they kill off Nova at least with the TA? They can. Wyvern gets 1.4k gold himself. Taffy. Gonna be jumped on, and TA wants to kill the Taffy, won't get it, he TP'd into the middle lane, and there's no GG call up until this point, but Pew Pew, they fought valiantly till the very end. So Pang 5, at the beginning, looked quite shaky, honestly, for Pang 5. Pew Pew, they looked pretty good for a while, but unfortunately, Lakels on the Invoker, their late game wasn't quite enough, the Templar Assassin just way too explosive, the Doom and the Lina even, all three heroes just being huge threats to Pew Pew, and they just didn't have enough control to really deal with them. So guys, thank you so much for tuning in to Pang 5 versus Pew Pew. This is going to conclude our first best of two series for the day. We've got a secondary series coming up after this, which is going to be Space Creators versus, let me check the schedule, Space Creators versus Execration. So if you guys want to tune in, definitely hang around. It should be starting in approximately oh, it's supposed to start in 2 minutes. So guys, stick around if you want to watch Space Creators versus Execration. And thank you so much for tuning in for this series. Guys, my name's Daniel Lee. If you like the cast, definitely give me a follow on my social media stuff. At Twitter, for example, at Daniel Lee Cast. Oh god, what was that? Anyways, if you don't know how to spell it, top right hand corner. Otherwise, you can take a look at the stream title. Thank you so much for tuning in. And I'll see you in roughly 2 minutes for Space Creators versus Execration. Stick around and I'll see you soon.